The story means a lot to me as a human and as a student as well. Imagine not being able to go to school, moreover, kindergarten, just because you have more melanin than other students and people from your community. Likewise, not being able to receive the same education you deserve as a human being. Hello, I'm Bowen Miller Richard from Secondary 3 Virtuoso, and for this year's microfilm, I would like to talk and tell a story about Veronica Williams. She faced horrible things, such as hate, backlash, criticism, death threats, and many more at the early age of 6, without committing a crime or doing anything bad to harm anyone or anything. An African-American woman who changed history once and for all, which is based on a true story. Enjoy. Sometimes people with different races can have life pretty rough, especially black people. Some people see them differently and treat them differently, which should not be the case at all. Well, unfortunately, this story is based on an outline just like that, yet it happened in real life. Veronica Williams was born on November 14th of 1954 on a small town of Mississippi. Just when Veronica was 4 years old, her family moved to New Orleans. She didn't live a wealthy life or childhood. While living in New Orleans, keep this in mind, her father worked at a gas station and her mother worked night jobs. Speaking of education, Veronica went to an all-black kindergarten since all schools back then in New Orleans were segregated, meaning black students went to different schools than other white students. To get to her school, she had to walk a long distance back and forth from home. In 1954, a decision called Brown versus the Board of Education, the U.S. Supreme Court made racial segregation against the law. Luckily, Veronica was chosen to be a candidate to attend an all-white elementary school, but only under one condition. The school board said black children can only attend this first grade if they were able to pass this complicatedly difficult test, so that not everyone can pass it. To make things even harder for them, if the African American children failed this test, New Orleans schools will have a higher chance of getting segregated for even longer period of time. Matters became worse for both Veronica's parents, since they worry if black kids who took the test fails and the future is in their hands. Though her father were against this idea, but her mother believed that she will be able to get a better education if he passed. As she believed in Veronica, she convinced her husband not just for them, but for all African American students, and of course it worked. The day finally came and Veronica, as a smart student, she took it and passed it, yet she even aced it. Veronica chose to attend the all-white school called William Franz. On the first day of school, November 14th, 1964, 4 US Marshals had to go to school with her to the front door. It wasn't smooth at all. When they arrived, angry crowds of parents and citizens that were against this shouted threats and tried to stop her from going to the school. It wasn't just her whom suffered from this. Others even tried to hurt her family, which led to her father losing his job. Veronica never missed a day of her school for a year. Although almost the whole society was against her, it didn't stop there. She had to sit alone in class since the parents of the other students were scared of the protesters, and some even decided to leave the school. Moreover, the ones who decided to stay there were often threatened and attacked by protesters, but not every time and every day were a storm for Veronica's family. Since both black and white people from their community began to show support in many different ways, years, months, and days went on, and parents gradually sent children back to the school, where Veronica attended and protesters seemed to lower down. Things went even better for Veronica after a year, since she was able to walk to school without the marshals and attended the classroom filled with both black and white students. I hope you enjoyed this story, and this type of situation did took place in the past, and racial discrimination continues till the day we live in today. Starting from first grade, Veronica attended all integrated schools until she graduated throughout her whole academic career. From one of the 4 marshals who sent to her school for 6 months continuously, one of them recalled from the first year of her school expressing how confident, brave, and full of courage she was back then. People like Veronica are sometimes degraded by some people we live in the world today, but everyone should know that they're nothing less of an average human being. But it's great to know that cases like these are decreasing and more people are showing love, kindness, and care to all types of people. And thank you so much for watching.